everybody, friends, the Circus, Country Fair. We learn a lot from each other. The Circus watches Country Fair work together. We see men and women doing all kinds of different jobs, helping each other out, not putting each other down, working together. The Circus, there's so many different jobs, men doing strongman jobs, women doing strong lady jobs, men looking pretty, ladies working hard. Circus, just like Oregon Country Fair, is about equality and equity. And that is why we give all of the hardest jobs to all of the hardest workers. Yeah. Right? This thing right here, it takes lots of work, practice, and dedication. This lady you're about to see has done hundreds of pull-ups and skipped thousands of cupcakes for your entertainment. Friends, make some noise. Thousands of cupcakes. She's made sacrifices for you people, writhing on the grounds in laughter and ecstasy right now. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together, and if you can't do that, make some noise with your mouth for the one and only Rebecca Palmer.
Stories again. Dutch. That's right, story time. Everybody loves story time. So now I'm going to tell a story of when I was 6 years old. And this is a true story. And first, the preamble to the story. When I was 6 years old, my parents were deadheads. That song right there. We have any Grateful Dead fans in this crowd? I was a little deadhead when I was six. That long hair, I was a hippie. It was pretty ridiculous. And I love that song. That was beautiful to put that on stage. Corey Palacios and the Rockin' Galoshes. Give him another round of applause, though. Okay, back to the real story. Story time 6 years ago. This song, this story is another one about inspiration. And this is one of those moments that really did change my life. And it all comes back in at the end. So when we were six, my family put us all in a little camper van. And we took a cross-country road trip. Now, I grew up in New York. I didn't have any circus in my blood. There was no performance art. There's none of that. I was like a science kid. And we stopped at the Franklin Institute in Philadelphia. Woo! Amazing museum. Like I said, I'm a science kid, science museum. That was my jam. That was mine. I loved it. And at that museum, I had my first real experience that I remember. Now, when you're 6 years old, you don't always remember everything, but you do remember moments. You remember those feelings, those things that stick with you your whole life. Maybe for some of you, this might be one of them. Who knows? Maybe just despair. So when I was six at the Franklin Institute in Philadelphia, I was put inside a bubble. It was magical. Changed my life. It gave me that spark of inspiration. It made me really feel that the magic is real out there. Magic is possible. And one of the great things about FAIR, flashing forward, right, 30 years, is all the great friends I've made here at the FAIR. All these beautiful people surround us, all these amazing artists and creators. And so I was telling this story to a man here at the FAIR, who's one of the elders, one of the people who really is this place. And I'm telling my story about being put in the bubble. And that man is Tom Noddy, the bubble magician himself. And Tom Noddy says to me, "Hey, where'd you say again that was? Philadelphia? Franklin Institute? What year? Like 1989? He's like, "That was me." Tom Noddy put me in a bubble when I was 6 years old. It changed my life. Now we're friends. I love that man. FAIR magic is real. Cherish the connections you make here. And with that, let me bring on stage another dear, dear friend of mine. The Gentleman Juggler. Coming back at you. Put them together for Curtis Carlisle.
kiss me.